Okay, students, this is the second part of functions. Students, functions topic is very, very, very important for us. Actually, you can treat it as the first chapter for calculus. Okay, yesterday I started the definition of function. Function is a special type of relation. Okay, what is the special in a relation? R, if R is a relation from A to B, so that all the elements of first set are used up and only once. Such relation is called functional relation. Definition of relation by using definition of function by use relation. So a relation is said to be a function. In that relation, no two ordered pairs have same first component. So another definition also given for function. Function has a rule. So every element of first set should be used up only once with some certain rule. Such rule is called a function. Function, association, mapping, all are same. For example, f is a function from A to B. Symbolically, you can write like this. Nana, A, you can read as f maps A to B. F maps A to B. Or f is a function from A to B. Or sometimes you can write like this also. So f is a function from A to B. Here A is called domain of the function. B is called codomain of the function. F of A is called range of the function. Range of f of A. Notation important. F of A. Set of images of A. I will show you. This is B A, this X Y, this is A B C, X is paired with A, Y is paired with B, then I can say that F is a function from A to B. What the domain means, set X Y. What the codomain means, set A comma B comma C. What the range means, set A B only. So that's why range is denoted by F of A, set of images. So always range is a subset of codomain. Okay, this is a what I explained yesterday. Next thing is f maps A to B. If A is a part of real number or A subset of real number, f is called real variable function. B is a subset, or then f is called real valid function. Both A and B are subset or functions are called real functions. Our functions are real functions only. Okay, students, listen. Domain and range, finding domain and range. Before that, again I want to explain another definition of function. Actually, what old definition of function? For example, the variable y and x are related in this manner, y equal x plus 1. Here I can say that y is a dependent variable and x is independent variable, because here y is made a subject. The value of y is depend upon the value of x. So old definition of function is dependent variable is called function with respect to independent variable. Here y is called function with respect to x. Y is called function with respect to x. If x is 1, what is y? 2. X is 0, what is y? 1. X is root 2, what is y? Root 2 plus 1. The value of y is depend upon the value of x. Here y is dependent, x is independent. In general, dependent variable is called function with respect to independent variable. I can say that y is a function with respect to x. What the rule means, what the rule of the function means, I can say x plus 1. How can you write that? F of x equal to x plus 1, you can write. But what the rule means? F of x x plus 1. The function f satisfied by this rule. F of x equal x plus 1. So, put x equal to 1, what will get y? 2, that is nothing but f of 1, I can say. F of 1 means y only. So functional value at x equal to 1, f of 1 means. So f of 1 equal to y. So what is the y mean here? 2. Okay. So what second last definition and important definition? Dependent variable is called function with respect to independent variable. For example, area of a circle is dependent upon radius. That's why area is called function with respect to its radius. That's why I can write f of r equal to pi r square. Okay. So, dependent variable is called function with respect to independent variable. And this is the rule of the function. This is the rule of the function. Okay, students. So, what type of functions we are dealing here? Real functions. Real. domain and codomain both are subset to real numbers. Listen students, a relation f, relation I'm saying clearly, I mentioned a relation, I don't need function or not, a relation f is defined from R to R by the rule f of x equal to 1 by x. Now I want to check whether this relation gives functional relation or not. Okay, observe students, a relation f from R to R, f is a relation, I'm clearly mentioned here, relation R to R defined by this rule, under this rule. Under this rule only you want to map the elements of domain to elements of the codomain. So, 1 is given, belongs to R only. What is the image of 1? What is the image of 1? F of x means what? Y only, no? Y equal to 1 by x. X is 1, what is y? 1 only. So, 1 is paired with 1. Okay. Yeah, 2 is taken, x is taken as what should pair, be paired with 1 by 2. Okay, so minus 1 is given, it should be paired with minus 1. 0 is given, 0 will be in R, 0 will be in R. What is the image of 0? 1 by 0. 1 by 0 not a real number, that's why there is no image for 0 here. There is no image for 0. So root 2 is taken, so this should be paired with 1 by root 2. Except 0, every element of R have images. That's why this is not a function. Why it is not a function? All the elements of domain are not used up. Just 0 is not used up. What is the meaning of that? All are not used up. Okay, what I can say? This is a only relation, not functional relation. But I want to make it into a functional relation. What I should do? Just modification. You need to change the domain. You need to change the set. From the set, if you remove 0. So, like this, R minus set 0 to R under this rule. So, 0 is not there, no? Every element, for example, 2 is there, 1 by 2 can pair with. 7, 1 by 7, root 2, 1 by 2. All elements will first set have images in second set. If 0 is taken, 0 doesn't have an image, but 0 is not there in the domain. Now we can say that it is a functional relation. Understood? Means what happened? A relation f defined from R to R by the rule f of 1 by x. This rule doesn't give functional rule. It is only relation. Okay. If you modify this first set, if you modify domain of the relation, then it become a functional relation. Okay. Okay. But how will the last question? Observe student. If a function defined by f of x equal to 1 by x, then find its domain. Meaning important. A function, if you are not mentioned what is the domain and codomain, if not mentioned means R to R, you assume that R to R. A function R to R defined by f of x 1 by x, then find its domain. Actually, R to R, the rule 1 by x doesn't give functional rule. You know that 0 doesn't have an image. But what is the question? If a function defined by f of x 1 by x, then find its domain. Domain means we want a modified domain of the relation that become the domain of the given function. What should, instead of x, you can't take 0. That's why I can say directly. So, listen students, the rule I will write again. The rule is f of x is called 1 by x. So, generally, important notation, f is a function from A to B, x is the element in a domain, y is the element in codomain. If x is paired with y, then y is called image of x. You can write y is equal to f of x. This is very, very, very important notation. So, y is equal to f of x means y is the image of x under the rule f. So, instead of this f of x, now I write y equal to 1 by x. So, meaning of the domain I want to explain now. What the meaning of the domain? What values of x, y is real? That is domain of the function. you are not mentioning what the domain to domain and codomain. R to R, we assume that R to R. What type of functions you are dealing in are real functions. No? Domain is a part of R and codomain also part of R. That's why the question is, find the domain of the function means indirectly, what values of x your y is real. That is the meaning. That is the domain. Domain means what x belongs to R, okay, y also belongs to R. So in this way I can say domain means what x belongs to R, y also belongs to R. If you take x equal 0, y is not real number. X is 2, y is a real number. X is root 2, y is a real number. Okay, what is the meaning of that? Except 0, anything you can take x. That's why what I can say, domain of the function equal to all real numbers except 0. So this is the meaning of the domain. Okay, how to find range? That is different. What is the range? Now I will explain the meaning. So what is the function on here? F of x is equal to 1 by x. What is the domain? Just now you got domain. Domain is all real numbers except 0. Substitute all real numbers except 0 in x. What will get outputs? That is called range of the function. That is called range of the function. Okay. Another words, I can say that y is equal to 1 by x. Take any value of x except 0. What will get y? Put x equal to 1, y equal to 1. Put x equal to 2, y equal to 1 by 2. Put x equal to 1 by 2, y equal to 2. Put x equal to minus 1 by 2, y equal to minus 2. Put x equal to root 2, y equal to 1 by root 2. What I am saying? What is this? Range. Should say range. All real numbers are getting, no? Somebody will make mistakes. They will say that all real number, not like that. To find the range of this function, especially simple function, no? Find the range of this function, meaning is important. Range means after substituting x values, x are called inputs, y are called outputs. See, arrow, x to y. For this function, x is said to be input and y is said to be output. Input is called domain, output is called range. So, what am I asking here? What are the outputs? The outputs are depend upon inputs only. No? What are inputs? R minus z0. So, outputs are depend upon inputs. That's why I'm asking what are the outputs means? 1, 1 by 2, 2. We can't write like that. No, we can't write like that. We want to write into set builder form. But the output should be written in set builder form. That is called range. So, observe students, to find range of the function, first of all, you should know inputs. Outputs are depend upon inputs. So, what are inputs? All real numbers except 0 are inputs. What are outputs should identify? To find the range of function, what real x, y real is domain. Reverse, what real y, x is real is become range. Reverse, find the rule, reverse rule here. So, x equal 1 by y, I can say, no? Just I interchange these two, what is the problem? So, now, what real y, x is real, it gives range. Reverse process. Okay. So, x, if y equal to 0, x is not real number. Observe now. Y equal to 0, x is not real number. What is the meaning of that? There is no image in a domain which have 0 as a pre-image. Sorry, 0 as an image. Okay, except y equal to 0, everything you can take. Now, I can say that the range of the function is all real numbers except 0. All real numbers except 0. I will show you, student. I will show you. Yeah. This is R minus at 0 to R. F is a function. What I'm asking? What are these values? Range. I'm not asking codomain. Codomain is R only. But what I'm asking? Range. What are the images? One is there. One. For some element of domain, it should be image. One. So 1 by x equal to 1 means 1 only. 1 should pair it with 1. So for example, 7 is given. 7 is given. What should write here? What is the element in domain so that 7 becomes its image? So just the rule should be equated to 7 only. 1 by x equal to 7. X equal 1 by 7. So 1 by 7 should be paired with this. But if 0 is taken, which element in the domain have 0 as the image should identify? Means what happened? 1 by x should be taken as 0. 1 by x is taken as 0, x is taken as 1 by 0, just like that operation not correct, just like what the meaning of that x is not defined, what the meaning of that there is no element in the domain, so that its image is 0. So this is range, you know, in the range 0 is not there, 0 is not image, means what is the meaning of that range of the function is all real numbers except 0. Student, especially for our class, very very difficult concept, nana. Functions, please, okay, practice all the concepts and all the problems. Without functions, you can't deal calculus. Okay, first chapter of calculus. Yeah, listen, students, my function is f of x equal 1 by x. My question is, and what rule this function, conditions this rule becomes a functional relation? One thing. After that, what is the domain? After that, what is the range? Difficult task, nana. Difficult task. Finding domains, ranges, not at all easy. Okay, for real functions. What I am saying, domain. Domain means, f of x means y only, no? So, y is equal to 1 by x is given. Domain means, what real x, y real. What real x, y real. Except 0, anything you can take in as x. That's why I can say that domain is all real numbers except 0. Range, reverse process. 1 by y. What real y? X should be real. Under condition. Don't think that always you can find range by using this this procedure. That is not correct. The range is dependent upon your domain only. The output is dependent upon your input only. So, in this example, I can say that real y, x is real. So, except 0. Y equal to 0, x is not real. What the meaning of that? Range also, all real number except 0. Okay, students? Yeah. No. Another example is simple example. A rule is given, f of x equal to root x. Given, functionally given this one. Function. Find the domain and range. Find domain of f and range of f. So, difficult problem this one also. Not difficult. For your sense, I am saying it difficult. Okay, f of x equal to root x. So, x is in domain, automatic image, it should be in codomain. So, I can say that y is the image of x, I can add y equal to f of x. So, I can say that y equal to root x. Just now explain what the meaning of domain. What real x, y is real. Okay. So, instead of x, you write minus 2, what happened? Observe, instead of x, you write minus 2, what happened? Root over minus 2, not a real number, no, it is complex number. That means x can't taken as minus 2. X can't taken as minus 2. So, put x equal to root over minus 1, not a real number. What is the meaning of that? Inside the square root, you can't take negative numbers. That is one thing. You take x equal to 0, root 0, 0 only, no? You can take 0, but you can't take less than 0. This is real number line, no? This is real number line. Here 0. These x values you can't take. Understood, no? What is the meaning of that? The domain of the function is all real numbers. 0 and greater than 0. Root is there, no? Root over. So, what I can say? Domain is closed 0 to infinity. Don't get 0, 1, 2, that is not correct. 0 to anything means 0.1, 0.001, 0.002. We can't write all, no? That this, I want to write the set builder form. Domain of the function is closed 0 to open infinity. This is the domain. Okay. But what is the range? That is interesting. Sometimes you need to use common sense to find the range of some functions, nana. So, y is equal to root. Root means what, nana? In mathematics, positive or non-negative, I can say. Root means non-negative, nana, in mathematics. Non-negative. So, y is always non-negative, the meaning of that. Y is always non-negative. So, what I can say, the range is closed to 0 to infinity. The range is closed to 0 to infinity. Y is root over, no? We won't get y is negative numbers. Because root over never negative. Anything you can take inside the roots. For 7 is taken, root 7 positive, root 6 positive, root 8 positive. Okay, that's why your y should be close to 0 to infinity. Sometimes your y also 0, no, if x is 0, y is 0 only. That's why range is close to 0 to infinity. For this function, domain is close to 0 to infinity. Range also close to 0 to infinity. Okay. Yeah, next example 3. Find domain of f of x equal to 1 by root over 1 minus x. Just I want to find domain, not range, domain. Students, listen, important topic, difficult one for you people. Finding domains and ranges. Okay, observe all of you. Yeah, let y is equal to 1 by root over 1 minus x. Why I am saying like that? Y is equal to f of x only, you know. Y is the image of x only. So what should find? What values of x, y is real. Already 1 is a real number, root over. So this should be positive. This should be positive. And also not equal to 0 also. Why? Because 1 by root over 0, 1 by 0 not defined. No. That's why your 1 minus x value is greater than 0. Important, your 1 minus x value should be greater than 0. What is the meaning of that? X is lesser than 1. X is lesser than 1. Understood? You know how to simplify simple inequalities. That's why I can say x is lesser than 1. Take number line. Lesser than 1 means all the values of x less than 1 I can take. All. So I can say domain equal to all real numbers. Sorry. Domain minus infinity to 1, open one not there, no? If you take x equal to 1, the y is not a real number. So minus infinity to 1 open is the domain of this function. In this way, you can find the domain and ranges. Just I want here domain only. That's why I found a domain. Students, important. For example, find the domain of f of x equal to root over x square minus 5x plus 6. Same. Y equal to root over x square minus 5x plus 6. What values of x by real? That is important. So this should be greater than 0 root over. And also 0 also, no problem. No? It is not in denominator. In previous example, root over is in denominator. That's why x should not equal to 0. But here x equal to 0, no problem. So what is the meaning of that? X square minus 5x plus 6 should be greater than or equal to 0. Such x values you want to find. Already I explained in basic inequalities. But anybody have any doubts about basic inequalities? Already uploaded several videos, inequalities by VGR. So please watch those videos. Then you people can understand how I am solving all these type of problems. So x square minus 5x plus 6 greater than or equal to 0. Such x value you want to find. I want to use wavy curve method or sine scheme method. Try to factorize this. That is x plus 2 into, sorry, x minus 2 into x minus 3 greater than or equal to 0. Next step is you need to take number line. Next step is you want to take zeros of this, 2, 3. Next step you want to identify these zeros will satisfy or not. R equal to that, 2 will satisfy, 3 will satisfy. Next plus, minus, plus. Greater symbols you want. So that I can say the dome of the function. Minus infinity to 2 closed, union closed, 3 to infinity. This is the domain of this function. Please students again watch those videos, because without those basic inequalities, you can't deal function concept and calculus concept. Okay? Okay, students. So, cubed root of x given. Again, confusion will start. Again, so many members will say that, sir, your x should be greater than or equal to 0. Closed 0 to infinity the domain. Wrong. Why it is wrong? All real numbers will satisfy. Cubed root negative number also real number only. You know, what is the problem? Cubed root of minus 2, minus 2 only. I'm not saying square root, cubed root. Square root of negative number not defined. Fourth root of negative number not defined. Not defined means not a real number. Sixth root of negative number not a real number. But cube root of negative real number, negative only, no? What the problem? Cube root negative real number, no problem. So sir, cube root of x means what should take instead of x? So y equal to cube root of x. Instead of x, anything you can take, any real number you can take. Then I can say that domain is all real numbers. Domain is all real numbers. Range also all real numbers. That's not a big problem. Okay, students? So for example, f of x is called 1 by cube root of x given. What is the domain of the function? Just now I explained, cube root of x, anything you can take instead of x, any real number you can take instead of x, then you cube root of x real number only, except 0, because this is in denominator. That's why I can say that domain of this function is all real numbers except 0. Okay? In this way, you can find domain of simple functions. Later, again, I will explain how to find domain and ranges of function. That only the difficult topic, the difficult concept in functions. Okay. Yeah. Before that, I want to again explain one thing. How to draw the graph of a function. For example, f of x is given in x plus 1. How to draw its graph? Already explained, no? Graph, how to draw the graph. You take coordinate plane. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. In trigonometry also I explained how to draw the graph of basic trigonometrical functions. So I don't want to waste my time. Directly I want to draw the graph of this. So what is the f of x means y only. Y equal to x plus 1. So every dot on coordinate plane followed by added pair. Every solution of this equation is in added pair. Every solution gives a dot on the coordinate plane. So find all dots, what you will get, that is called graph of that function. So x is 0, y is 1, x is minus 1, y is 0, x is 1, y is 2, like that. Several infinitely ordered bits you will get 0, 1, this is 1, this is 2, for example, this is minus 0, 1 here only. Okay, minus 1, 0 here only, 1, 2 here only. Take all such ordered pairs, you get a graph that is called graph of that function, curve you get, that is called graph of the function. So I can say this is the graph of y equal to x plus 1. Now the question is, this graph is functional graph or not? How to identify? That is important. If a function graph is given, how to identify the functional graph, that graph is gives function or not, or functional graph or not? So what is this? This is the graph of y equal to x plus 1. Or f of x x plus 1. A rule is given. This rule gives functional rule or not. But one of the ways, we need to find their solutions. We need to draw its graph. By using graph, you can say. So, I will explain, students. All these ordered pairs satisfied by this rule. That's why I want to write rule of that relation by mean of ordered pair. 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, so on. So, this is the relation. When this relation becomes functional relation, what the definition? No two ordered pair have same first component. No two ordered pairs have same first component. Means x value should not be same. X value should not be same. Then such relation is called functional relation. Here 0, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 0. But you can't write all infinitely many ordered pairs will be, no? We can't write all infinitely many ordered pairs and we can't identify, no? So, graphical you can identify, students, observe. Okay. 0, 1 means here only, no? 0, 1, 0. X 0, Y 1. Minus 1, 0. X minus 1, Y 0. 1, 2. X 1, Y 2. What do you mean that? We want to identify two different ordered pairs will have same X or not. That's all. What is the meaning of that? Do one thing. Draw a vertical line for this graph. Draw vertical line. Some anywhere draw vertical line. For example, this is one of the vertical line. Yeah, what is this point, Nana? 2, something only, no? 2, something. Correct or not? 2, something. Draw another vertical line. This is 2, something. Draw any vertical line. If those vertical line intersect the graph at only one point. Then the graph is said to be functional graph. Why? I will explain through another example. For example, this is the graph of a function. Wait. For example, this is a graph of a function, graph. Okay. So draw vertical line. If draw any vertical line, for example, this vertical line intersecting the graph at two different points. Now I can say that it is not a functional graph. How can you I say that is important? Students, reason, for example, this is point 2, Nana. The corresponding is 3, corresponding is 4. What is this ordered pair? 2 comma 3. What is this ordered pair? 2 comma 4. What the meaning of it? On this graph, two ordered pairs are there, 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4. If you write those ordered pairs in roster form, what will get 2 comma 3, 2 comma 4, so on. What the meaning of that? Two different ordered pairs having same first component. That's why this relation is not functional relation. What the meaning of that? This graph is not functional graph. Understood, students? What the meaning of that? If you draw a vertical line, if that vertical line intersects the graph at two different points, means that that graph will have two different y's with the same x. Means two ordered pairs will have same first component. Okay, so such situation can say that the graph is not gives functional graph. So what happened here? See, draw any vertical line, that those lines are intersecting graph at only one point. No? This line intersects graph at this point only. This vertical line intersects graph at this point only. This vertical line again won't intersect the graph. Means that given graph is a functional graph. But in this example, what happened? Again, I will show you none here. Again, I will show you. So this is the graph of a function for anything. So this is not called a functional graph. How can you say? So just draw a vertical line. Here draw a vertical line. This is not intersecting graph even at one point also. Okay. So draw here. It is not intersecting. But here what happened? This vertical line intersecting the graph at two different points means for same x you get two different y values. That's why it is not a functional graph. Here also it is not a functional graph. Okay. So this is called vertical line testing. Nana. Vertical line testing, where graph of a relation is given, that relation become functional relation or not, we want to identify by using vertical line test, we can identify. Students, once again listen. So this is a graph of a function. This is graph of a relation. Now we want to say that this relation is functional relation or not. We need to do draw vertical lines. See, vertical line intersecting at only one point. Draw another, intersect at only one point, another at only one point, another at only one point. So I can say that what is the relation satisfied by all ordered pairs, that is a functional relation, or this graph is a functional graph. So take another one. For example, circle is taken, just like graph also, that also graph of a relation. So now we want to check this relation gives functional relation or not. Vertical line test. Draw y vertical line. Vertical line means a line parallel to the y-axis. So this is the vertical line. What happened? This line intersecting the given graph at two different points. What is the meaning of that? Same for same x, we get two different y's. Means that this is not a functional graph. Okay. Students, listen. We can test a graph of a function for it is to be function. A vertical line would cut the graph of a relation that is not a function at least 2 points. On the other hand, a vertical line would cut the graph of the relation that is a function at most 1 point. What is given here? Just I explained. See here, this is not a functional graph because intersecting at two different points. This is not a functional graph because it intersects two different points. So this is also not a functional graph, intersecting several infinitely many points. Okay. These three are not functional graphs. Okay. So this is functional graph only. Intersect only draw any vertical line. Intersect at only one point. This is also functional graph. This is also functional graph. In this way, if a graph is given, you can check that graph gives functional graph or not.